Today we're taking a quick look at the color change and post-print functions in PrusaSlicer. You may be surprised by how powerful these tools are. Let's start with color print. Start by slicing the model as usual. Then go to the slicing preview and click on the plus icon on the right side of the screen. The color change will start at the beginning of the selected layer, not at the end of it. This is where people sometimes make a mistake, so double check the preview before you start the print. You can adjust the preview colors by right-clicking anywhere on the colored bar. You can also set a color change by right-clicking on the preview slider and selecting color change. This will bring up the preview color selection right away. Now, let's try to print something in color. It can be quite useful for making cool little paint prints, logos, rubber patches, and much more. Just don't mix different materials, they're most likely not going to stick to each other. As you have probably guessed, the color change is more about making the print look nice. The post-print function, on the other hand, is more about functionality. You can schedule pause by right-clicking on the preview slider and selecting Add Pause Print. Just like with the color change, the pause will happen right before printing the selected layer. You may even type in a message that will be displayed on the printer. So, what exactly can we use it for? Let's take a look at some examples. The most common way of using Pause Print is inserting nuts to make a nice and compact appearance of the model. All you need is to prepare holes with enough clearance. 0.15 mm in every direction should be enough. This clearance is a good start for more or less all inserted models, by the way. The next use of scheduled print pause is inserting magnets. It's great for printing tabletop games such as D&D or Catan. But there are a few things to consider. First, you need to find the magnet orientation. This can be tricky, so we suggest using a permanent marker to highlight the correct orientation. Next, secure the magnet with a drop of superglue. This will prevent it from sticking to the metal parts of your printer. Finally, spread a glue stick on top of it to improve filament adhesion. Sometimes you can use post print and color change both in the same print to make something nice and useful. You can try printing maracas, scuba rattles, whistles, and much more. The post print function also works great for various repairs. Take a look at this zipper pulley made with TPU and a piece of wire. This one has been working for 6 months. Then of course you can use post print for inserting electronics, making protective cases and even combining filament translucency and LEDs. Another fantastic use case of pausing the print is to make objects heavier. This can be done with epoxy resins, plaster or even sand. You just need to be really careful. Any mistake might damage the printer. You can also pause the print and insert a large metal profile. This way, even a thin and tall part can become really strong. Finally, we have a simple hack for printing perfect horizontal overhangs and bridges with flexible filaments. Simply design and print the supports with another material, such as PLA for example. This is actually much better than using regular TPU supports, isn't it? We hope that this gave you some ideas on how to improve your prints, and we're looking forward to see your creations. Happy printing!